If it turns over, but it's not starting, that means there is no synchronization between the engine computer and the actual security system. Security system is divided into a couple parts. Key, EWS, engine computer. Hello everybody, you're watching this YouTube channel. My name is Valentin, and today's video will talk about BMW security system. The internet trying to find out something that will help me to understand how BMW system is actually operating. What is a security system? What it contains? What is it doing? I mean, I did find some information, but nobody really breaks it down into something that everybody can understand. So I decided to take everything in my hands, and that's why today I'll try to explain to you how this system is working, since this is what we do for a living. I have a little bit of idea how this system is operating. What is actually an immobilizer? Immobilizer, it's a part of the security system, because immobilizer, it's an actual computer, or if you will, module, that contains information such as a VIN number, codings, your key information, password. It also communicates with the engine computer, in some cases with the transmission computer at the same time. So what BMW security system is? It's like a set of modules. It's a chain that prevents your vehicle from stealing it. Let's say if you bring another key from another BMW and try to start your vehicle, it won't start because the key is not recognized by your security system, and vice versa. So this is what the security system is, exclusively to prevent your vehicle from stealing. So let's begin with EWS2. The EWS2 module looks like this. Okay, this black box, even on the very bottom of it, it says EWS2 right here. So you can clearly see that this is EWS2 module, and this EWS2 module contains your vehicle's information, right? It works the following way. You have key, you have immobilizer, and also you have engine computer, right? That goes next to the immobilizer. Step one, you insert the key into the ignition switch. The electrical magnetic field is generating power around this key. The key powers up. Step two, EWS module is sending signal to the key in order to read the information. So basically, EWS module is asking, hey, key, do you belong to this car? The key inside contains a thing called a password, not the actual key, the transponder. So the transponder contains the password inside of the key. If this password match password inside of the EWS module or immobilizer is actually activating itself. And next thing it does, it changes a rolling code. It's a special code that constantly moving forward, and there is no way you can calculate it backwards. It also calculates itself on the forward. So it goes forward, it moves on, and as soon as it writes this information, the EWS saves this rolling code. And after that, it sends a reply back to the key with the new rolling code that was stored inside of the EWS. As soon as the key receives that data, it stores the information inside of the actual transponder, and then it replies back saying, yes, I stored this information and I have new rolling code installed right now. The EWS module receives the signal back, and as soon as this whole chain of processes is done, then the vehicle is ready to start, and it will start spinning your starter. Why? It's because the EWS module contains inside the starter relay. So if you're looking for a relay, specifically a starter relay, and you find yourself in a situation where you put the key in and there is no even crank, like you're trying to start the vehicle but it's not even cranking, probably first thing in your head would be, oh, maybe my relay is bad. But hang on, BMW does not have any external relays to power your starter. The relay is inside of the EWS module, right? It's also inside of the CAS module. So, oh, since we're talking about EWS, it's inside of the EWS. So this relay is going to turn on only if it recognizes the key and the key properly responds back to the mobilizer. So once this process is done, relay is activated and then it supplies the starter with 12 volts that's ready to spin when you try to start the vehicle. That's why, you know, when you try to start your vehicle, it cranks but won't start. It's probably because engine computer not operable, or if it's working, then probably it's not programmed correctly to the immobilizer. So again, just to clarify everything, you take the key, put it into the ignition switch, it generates electromagnetic field, feeds the transponder with power. The key is not sending any signal first. First is the EWS sending signal to the key. Once the key responds with the proper password that fits this immobilizer, then immobilizer starts rolling our security code, right? The code rolling code. Now, once the rolling code is changed inside of the EWS, it's sending a reply back to the key with the same rolling code. So basically, rolling code is contained inside of the key, inside of the immobilizer. Once this whole process is complete, the engine starts spinning. Then EWS sends the signal to the DME in order to fire the engine. So this is EWS2, and this is how EWS2 is working. Now, in the next video, we'll talk about EWS3, and EWS3 is a little bit more complicated, and there are actually more versions of EWS3 that exists, and I'll discuss every single one and explain you the difference between others. But principle is going to be the same, just with some extra addings to this whole process. So nothing too complicated. It's pretty easy. It's pretty simple. It's just something that you have to understand and process in your head. And this is only exclusively BMW. Mercedes is not working that way. And any other vehicle is not working that way. It's similar, but it's different. If you like this video, and if this video was helpful for you, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell following the subscribe button. Okay, that will help us to grow the community and share our knowledge with everybody. All right, thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned with the next video and see you in the next one. Bye.